Hey guys, welcome back to my channel SAP with IK. Hope you're all doing good. So today in this video we'll be discussing on the batch determination process in the process order. So let's get started. So before we move further, we should basically understand what is the purpose of the batch determination in the process order. So typically in the pharma industry, while you are manufacturing a product, so let's say in this case we are manufacturing a capsule, right? So to manufacture the capsule, we would need a set of components or the raw materials, right? So on this particular quantities, like the RM1, the raw material 1 will be needed for 100 kg, raw material 2 with 50, and raw material 3 for 20 kg to manufacture the final product. So while consuming the components, so let's say in the stock for the RM1, we got three batches available. So we have B1, B2, B3. So these three are the batch numbers, and these three batches have the sufficient quantity in order to meet the requirement. So here our requirement for RM1 is basically 100 kg, but when we look at the multiple batches, we have more than enough stock to meet the requirement, right? So now, based on the classification of the characteristics, the system should be able to identify which is basically the suitable batch. So now on these three batches, there might be several characteristics that the quality person has basically inspected while receiving the raw materials from the supplier, right? So for the batch B1, let's say we have two characteristics that will be evaluated basically. One is the SA value, and the second one is the loss of dry. So these two are the characteristics which will define the potency of this particular batch B1. So in the same way, each of these batches will have their own potency values based on the characteristic evaluation or while performing the quality inspection of the incoming materials, right? So each of these batches have their own characteristics. In the same way, the RM2 has got three batches again, like C1, C2 and C3. And which has more than the required quantity, by which basically suits to the consumption process. So there are several criteria that can basically help us to identify the right batch. So let's say I'm going to classify these batches based on my last goods receipt date, or it can be based on the first expiry date, right? So let's say out of these three batches, the B1, B2 and B3, the B2 batch has got less expiry date. So the shelf life of the B2 is less when compared with the B1 and B2. So now during the consumption, in order to make this possible in the system, we have to define these characteristics like the shelf life or the last date of goods receipt or the potency values such as SA and LOD. So these parameters will be defined as characteristics for each and every batch. And based on the result recording the QA person is going to do, the characteristics gets updated into this particular batch. So let's have a look on the prerequisites in order to activate the batch determination in the process order. So let's start with the configuration part. So to enable the configuration, we basically need to activate a few configuration steps for the batch management. So in order to navigate to this particular view, you can actually go to the SPRO, the IMG path, and under that you will have the logistics general. So under logistics general, you will see a node for the batch management. So under the batch management, you will see the batch determination and the batch check node. So if you open that, there you will find several configurations that you have to activate for the process order level. So let's have a look on that in more detail. So coming to the configuration steps, as part of the condition tables, we have to define the process order for the condition tables. And then we have to define the process order access sequence, and then the process order strategy types, and then the search procedure for the process order. And then we are going to assign the search procedure to the process order and activate the checks. So we will go through this in more detail once we log into SAP. So basically, these are the sequence of the configurations that we have to perform in order to activate the batch determination in the process order. So coming to the master data side, these are the prerequisites we have to follow in sequence. The first one is basically to activate the batch management for the raw materials or the semi-finished. So basically for the components which you would like to have the batch determination be active. So for those items, you have to basically activate the batch management in the material masters. And then we are going to create the characteristics for the batch characters that should be part of the classification or the selection criteria. And then we are going to create a class, and this class will be assigned to the components as part of the bill of material. So that will be used in the batch determination process. So once we create the class, we are going to assign the characteristics that we have created here into the class. And then in the fourth step, we are going to assign the characteristics to this particular class, right? And then we are going to create the sort sequence. So this basically determines like in which sequence, like in the ascending order or the descending order, should the characteristics be classified. And the final step is basically to create the batch search strategy. So let's look at the transaction codes for these checks. So the first one, to activate the batch management, we use the transactions MM01 or MM02. Like if you're creating a new material, so you can activate it at the time of the creation itself. But if you're going to activate it for an already existing material, then you're going to use the transaction MM02. So before you activate the batch management for these materials, you have to make sure that there is no stock available for those items in the plant. So if you have a stock existing already, which is not batch managed, and you would like to activate the batch management at a later stage, so there will be a different set of procedures to activate the batch management. Like you have to clear the complete stock, and then you have to activate the batch management checkbox. So once we have the master data, the material codes in place, we're going to create the characteristics in the transaction CT04, and then the creation of the class in transaction CL01. So to assign the characteristics to the class, you can either do it while creating the class, or if the class is already existing, you can use the change mode of the class in CL02 and assign. And then with the sort sequence, you're going to use the transaction CU70. And for the batch search strategy, you're going to use the transaction COB1. So while creating the search strategy, it basically depends on the combination of the order type, the plant, and the materials. So that depends on the strategy type you have actually configured for that particular process. So here I'm in SAP. So first, let me show you the configuration steps. So I'm navigating to the SPRO or the IMG path. And here I'm going to find the logistics general node. So under that we have the batch management, and under the batch management we do have several parameters. So I'm going to choose the batch determination and batch check. So under this we will find the condition tables, the action sequences, the strategy types, all these steps what we have discussed earlier. So once you open the condition table, you can see that there are several parameters where you can actually create the condition table. So one is basically to define the inventory management condition table, and then we have a different condition tables for the production orders, process orders, sales orders, and also the warehouse management process. So in the same way, we will see the similar criterias or the similar parameters in each of these nodes, like the access sequences, we have those five characters, and then under the strategy types we do have those five. And similarly, we can see that in the batch search procedure as well. So let's start with the condition table first. So in the condition table, if I click on the process order, since we are using the process industry example, I'm going to use the process order, and I'm going to click on the define process order condition types. So here, if you would like to create a new condition type for the process order, so you have to choose the create condition table. But since it is already created, then I'm going to just display what is readily available. So here we can see two tables that are actually available. So one is the combination of the order type, the plant, and the combination. And the second one is the order type, plant, the production material, and the component. So these are basically helpful in order to perform the search procedures for that particular process order type, right? So since it is already available, sometimes this setup will be readily available. So I don't think you will have a need to create a new one unless you choose a different set of parameters, right? So once the condition table is defined, we then go to the access sequences. So even this is the same, like this is pre-configured, and I don't think we need to have a need to create a new access sequence here. So the access sequence we have here is CO01, 02, and KF01. So each of these will have their own field. So let's say for the CO01 and look at the access sequences. So I can see that this 030, which is already created as part of the condition table, that has been assigned to this particular access sequence, 001. So I don't want to make any changes here. So I'm going back. And coming to the strategy types, here we have the flexibility basically to create our own strategy types, right? By using the previous conditions or the previous configurations we have done. So let's say, for example, the strategy type CO01, I'm going to just select this and show you the values here. So under this particular condition type, we are basically using the class type as 023, which is basically for the batches, and the number of splits the batch determination can actually split the batch quantities. So that can be enabled here, like 999, which is the max level. And if any changes allowed, and the dialog batch determination and the quantity proposal. So these are pretty much standard, right? So we don't want to disturb anything here. So once the strategy types are assigned, we are going to then create the batch search procedure for the process order. So here we also have a flexibility to create our own customized procedures. So let's take an example of this YB01. So under this search procedure, I've assigned two condition types. One is the CO01, which we have seen earlier, and then the customized condition type here. So let me go back. So once this is done, then we are going to create the batch search procedure allocation. So under this, we will have a different node to assign the batch search procedure to the process orders. So here we are going to assign the search procedure that we have configured in the previous step to the order type and the plan combination, right? And we are going to check this box to check the batch. So this checkbox is basically to evaluate that the batches, in case the user has entered a batch manually, right, and ignoring the batch determination proposed by the system. So in that case, system is going to evaluate those characteristics of that particular batch, whether they fit into the selection criteria or not. So that's all about the configuration, the class creation. So I'm going to use a transaction CL03 to look at the class, which is already created. But if you want to create a new class, you have to use CL01. So here I have my class created, and these are my characteristics. So you know that you can use an existing or a standard characteristic that is already available in the system. But if something is not there, then I think you have to create a new characteristic and then assign it into the class, right? So, but here we are not going to assign any values for these characteristics. So once we have the characteristics created, we are going to assign these characteristics into the class. That's it. So the classification part is completed. And then we are going to take a look at the material master of the raw material. So this is my raw material. So in the classification view for the raw material, I'm going to assign the class ID here. So based on the class here, the selection criteria will basically pick this particular material into the batch determination process. And then based on the characteristic values or the characteristics that we have assigned here, the selection criteria would be done for the respective batches. So the next step is basically to create the search procedure. So in COB1, we are going to basically define the combination of the order type, the plant, and the component. So based on these three conditions, what should be the selection criteria or the parameters through which the batch should be selected by the system. So here I'm going to enter the raw material. So this is basically the combination that will be used in this particular order type and the plant combination, right? So once you enter the material, so select that particular row and then click on the selection criteria. So here you're going to use the same class that we have used earlier in the material master. So the characteristics that I have as part of the class are going to populate here, and then I'm going to enter the selection criteria where the expiration date should be more than 01/01/2020 or maybe 21, and the SA value probably it can be in a particular range from 95 to 100%. Sorry, it should, you have to make a space. And the loss of dry here or the LOD value, it should be, let's say, less than 20%, right? So based on these selection criteria or the parameters that we assign here, system is going to read the batches for this raw material only if these conditions are satisfied. So let's say if there is a batch where the expiration date or the SA value is not within the range. So let's say the SA value is basically 90%, but my selection range is basically 95%, right? So this, this characteristic is not satisfied. So the batch will be ignored during the selection process. So once you create this strategy type, you're going to go back one step and then choose the raw material and then click on sort. So the sort function basically helps us to identify the particular sorting sequence. So if we have already created a sorting rule earlier, we are going to use that here. So that will be created in the transaction CU70, like we have seen here. So in the sorting rule, we are going to, this is actually predefined, right? So when you create the sort rule in CU70, you're going to create these characteristics and also choose that the sorting should be done in the ascending order, or it can be on the descending order as well. So based on your requirements. So let's take a look at the sort rule as well in CU70. And this is my sort sequence. Sorry, I'm going to the change mode and click on the characteristics. So here we have assigned those three characteristics that will be part of the sort sequence. And here you can choose whether this particular characteristic, so let's say the expiration date, should it be based on the ascending order or the descending order? If I choose the descending order for the characteristic expiration date in the sort sequence, so the batch that has the oldest value or the highest date, right? So let's say we have two batches. So one batch will be expired in 2022 and the second batch will be expired in 2024. So if I choose the descending order, so the batch with the expiration date of 2024 will be selected here. But if I choose the ascending order and remove this, so the batch with the expiration date in 2022, that will be considered first. Okay, so that's how the sort function basically works. So now we have created the characteristics and we have created the class and we assign the characteristics to the class, and then we have created the sort sequence, and then we have assigned the sort sequence and the selection criteria in COB1. So the next step is basically to look at the batch determination procedure in the process order. So let's go to COR1. I'm going to create a new process order. And here my base quantity is of 360 kgs. Okay. So now I'm going into the material list. So from here I can see that these three are the components that are basically needed to manufacture the 360 kg of this semi-finished item, right? And here we do have the storage locations already predefined, and all these three materials are batch managed. So you can see a checkbox here in this particular field, like the batch key. So if there is an X here, it means that these three materials are batch managed. So now to perform the batch determination in the process order, there are two methods. One is for the user to choose the item and do the batch determination manually. Like he can see it in the foreground, like what batches are being determined. And the second option is basically to automatically create the batch determination based on the selection criteria while releasing the process order, right? So let's have a look on these two processes. So first we will look at the automatic creation of automatic batch determination while releasing the process order. So let me just approve this process order. Approval has been given, and when I click on release, so before that let me show you the component list. So there are no batches assigned here, so I'm going to release the process order now, and you can see that automatically the batches for the raw materials have been created by the system itself based on the selection criteria. So let's say now in a different scenario where the user would like to see the determination in the foreground. So let's see that example as well. So I'm going to the transaction. I'm going to the transaction COR1 again, just to create the order one more time. Go to the material list, select the components, and then click on this double flask or the execute batch determination. So once you click on this, from here we can see that there are two batches available for the raw material with this much of available quantity, and this is the storage location. But based on the selection criteria, system has basically picked the first batch, like 121, right? So here in the characteristic sorting, we can see why it basically happened, like based on what selection criteria. So in the sort sequence, we basically defined that the expiration date should be in the ascending order, right? So the batch that will expire soon, that should be consumed first, right? That's a rule that we defined in the selection criteria. So if you look at these two batches, the first batch, it has the expiration date in 27/3/2021. So this should be consumed first, right? And the second batch, it has enough shelf life to wait until 2022. So that's the reason it has not been consumed, allocated by the selection criteria. So if you feel that this is okay, you're going to copy the batch. And then the second raw material appears in the sequence. So for this again, we can see there are almost six batches with all these characteristics. And based on the date, as you can see here, the first expiry date has been considered by the selection criteria. So I'm going to copy this. And this is the third raw material. So it has got only one batch. So it has just copied that based on the selection criteria here. So I'm going to copy this. So now we can see that all the batches got assigned here based on the selection criteria rules. So once the batch has been allocated, so then the user can actually go and release the process order. So in the overall process, like we have seen with the manual batch determination and the automatic batch determination while releasing the process order, I would like to show you the configuration where you can actually enable this. So that will be in the production scheduling profile where you can navigate through the transaction COry. So I'm going to choose the production scheduling profile and go into the details of it. And under the automatic batch creation, you will see several options here. So should the batch determination happen at the time of order release or at the time of order creation, or no automatic batch determination is needed? So if I choose no, then it means that the user should actually manually perform the batch determination like we have seen in the manual method. And the allocation of the search procedure to the process order types is basically done in the order type dependent parameters. So where you can navigate with the transaction COR4. And then click on the plant and the order type combination, go into the details of it. So in the tab planning, you have a section for the batch determination, right? Search procedure. So here we can actually allocate the customized or the standard search procedures that we have actually configured during the process. That's all for today, guys. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Also click on the bell icon to receive updates. We'll meet again soon in our next video. Until then, take care, stay safe, stay healthy. Bye.